Thanks a lot, Professor, for those words from your heart. Dr. N. Gopalakrishnan is not very new to our VSC. He is a renowned speaker. He is the co-founder and presently director of Indian Institute of Scientific Heritage, Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. His research career spans 28 plus years about Indian culture and heritage. He completed PhD biochemistry and dealt about science in Sanskritam. He has extensive knowledge on Indian scriptures, including Vedas and Upanishads. He delivered more than 4,000 lectures across the globe on topics ranging from science and spirituality. He is working with the mission of creating a university similar to Takshashila, Nalanda, to where thousands from other countries came and learned about our science and spirituality in those ages. He wrote more than 200 books and thousands of hours of videos. Video lectures are available online in YouTube. They are viewed and read by lakhs of people across the globe. Now, the moment that we have been waiting for. I invite Dr. N. Gopalakrishnan to deliver his address on rejuvenating Indian scientific heritage.
Most respected Swamijis, professors, faculty members, and my dear young brothers and sisters, plus parents, my pranams to each and every one of you. For the last 28 years, I was not doing research on heritage, but working as a CSIR scientist for 25 years. For the last 45 years, I was fortunate enough to glance through our heritage and other subject. Here I have given 45 minutes. I would like to give you few points. When you go from this auditorium out, these points should be in your memory. All are practically implementable messages. First point, I would like to request you a small message to be kept in your mind. Remember that we are not permanent in this world. We are not permanent in this world. Last century, this day, we were not here. Next century, this day also, we will not be here. How long we are living is less important. How we are living is more important. How long we are living can be answered something like 26,500 days. Every day we may be breathing about 23,080 times. Every breath is taking you towards graveyard. A day will come, we will have to go from here. The answer for how long you are living is clear, 26,500 days. Answer for how you are living, I am living a useful, fruitful, purposeful and meaningful life. I am living a useful, fruitful, purposeful, meaningful life. And for which you have to do listening, watching, discussing and thinking. Listening, watching, discussing and thinking. And Vivekananda studies of people should do double of that. Listening and making others listening, watching and making others watching, discussing and making others discussing, and thinking and making others thinking. That should be their dharma, not a duty. Dharma is different from duty. Dharma is equal to duty plus responsibility plus privilege. Dharma is equal to duty plus responsibility plus privilege of an individual. Dharayati iti dharma, dharanat dharma. Whichever is guiding you, directing you, motivating you, instructing you, showing you the pathway, that is dharma. And in that dharma, remember that you have got modern knowledge developed for the last 150 years, which is there in 180 degree in front of you. The last 150 years of modern knowledge. There is another 180 degree behind you. That is the knowledge existed in Mesopotamia, Babylonia, Greek, Rome and China. Absolutely nothing remains now. 3 months back, I was fortunate enough to go to China, Shanghai and Beijing. I found only Tiananmen Square and a dead body of Mao. Nothing else. In China, nothing is remaining. Greek, nothing is remaining. Babylonia, nothing is remaining. Mesopotamia, nothing. And Egypt, only pygmies and pyramid. But in India, for the last right from BC 8275, BC 8275 up to 2012, 10,000 years of heritage exist. So 180 degree behind you can give you 10,000 years of knowledge from India. Integrate the 180 behind you with the 180 in front of you. Slowly change man-making word into men-making. Slowly change the bouquet of fruit to bouquet of book. So the fruit will be over by tomorrow morning, but book will not be over. And so this changing is needed. I think Swami Vivekananda's message given by Yamadharma Raja to Nachiketas Uttishtata Jagrada Prapyavarani Bodhada is wrongly conveyed. Slightly wrongly, not completely wrongly. Uttishtata Jagrada Prapyavarani Bodhada. Arise. Awake, stop not till the goal is achieved is not the meaning. Uttishtada, gloriously stand up. Jagrata, be aware that you are not permanent here. Prapyavarani bodhada, enlighten yourself by acquiring knowledge from the scholars. That is the literal meaning. Not that I created it. Uttishtada, gloriously stand up. Jagrata, be aware that you are living in this jagat. Jagat means which has got birth, sustaining and death. So jagrata, be aware that you are not permanent here. In the transformer also it is written jagratai. Why it is written? You are born and you are living till now, and by catching in that transformer, don't be over. That is why Uttishtada Jagrata Prapya, acquiring varan, knowledge from the scholars. Nibodada, enlighten yourself. Kshurasya dhara nishida duratyaya durgam padastat kavayo vadandi. That is also to be added with that. So enlighten every day, every minute, leading a useful, fruitful, purposeful and peaceful life. By addition, deletion, modification and correction. By listening, watching, discussing and thinking. And change the mind towards fearless. Thoughts will become fearless. Action will become fearless. Result will become fearless. Reward. Mind, thoughts, action, result, reward. 5 points. Focus on again 5 points. Mind, body, family, dharma, nation. Always elevate your mind, elevate the mind, and that too by giving positive messages, positive experiences and positive stories. Convert the mind from asatoma sadgamaya, convert the mind from tamasoma jyotirgamaya, convert the mind from mrityorma amritam gamaya. Elevate the body. Don't create the sacred body with the flesh and blood of dead animals. that this body, idam shariram kaunteya, kshetram ityabhidhiyate. This is from Bhagavad Gita. Since you are all Indians, you might not have read Bhagavad Gita. So, this body is the sacred temple. So, elevate that body with whatever is deserved for this body. And family relation, it is not like Western relation. Matra Devo Bhava, Pitra Devo Bhava, Acharya Devo Bhava, Atithi Devo Bhava, Rashtra Devo Bhava. First comes mother, second father, third Acharya, and so on. So elevate the mind. Uddhare Atmanatmanam. Na Atmanam Avasadaye, Atmaiva Hyatmano Banduho, Atmaiva Ripuryatmana. The most glorious and glorious sentence from Bhagavad Gita out of 701 stanza, 6th chapter, 5th line. Elevate yourself. Uddhare Atmanatmanam. Na Atmanam Avasadayet. Never denigrate yourself. Atmaiva Hyatmano Binduhu. You yourself is your closest relative. Atmaiva Ripuryatmana. You yourself is your closest enemy too. Elevating by integrating the old knowledge and modern knowledge. Almost 8 minutes over out of 45 minutes. So, integrating the old and new, that is our theme today. And in the area of science, we have got a wrong notion, as Swami Vivekananda used to tell. Americans used to tell that we are a scientific country. We are a rich country, economically the most developed country in the world. So we do not want other things. Swami Vivekananda used to tell one lie. My dear friends, you have got a wrong notion. You think that the good increases continuously and evil decreases continuously. And you think that a day will come only good remain and evil will disappear. Am I talking to you with the fast English? Speed is more? Okay, so again, repetition. You have got a wrong notion that good increases continuously and evil decreases continuously. Wrong. When the good increases, evil will also increase. Not my words, Swami Vivekananda. So how to solve this evil or reduce the evil? Integrate the good from the east with the good from the west. That only India can do it. Sometimes I used to say, God sent his prophet to Saudi Arabia and God sent his son to Israel. God came here 10 times. Maybe because 125 political parties are here. Still India is great. India is literally great. 10 times God came here. He saw us. Pig also. Never God venture to come in other country as pig. Varaha avataram. So integrate the good. For which we have got lot of science. We have got a wrong notion. First wrong notion, everything existed in Veda. Wrong. Everything is not present in Veda. Vedas go through a different part. It integrates science and definitely some scientific material. Eka chame, tisrashchame, panjajame, saptajama, navajama, eka dashajame, trayo dashajame, panjadashajame, saptadashajame. Arithmetical progression is there. Ekam cha dasham cha dasham cha shatam cha shatam cha sahasram cha sahasram cha ayudam cha ayudam cha prayudam cha prayudam cha niyudam cha niyudam cha arpudam cha arpudam cha niyarpudam cha. Geometrical progression is there. Sesam cha me shyamam cha me trapus cha me urk cha me sunrata cha me. Metals are mentioned in that one, it's all right. And like that, some informations are there. But not everything. Everything is not there in Vedas, and we need not say that when everything is there. Some people used to say nothing is there in India, only zero is there. It is told in the reverse also. We discovered zero, what we discovered is only zero. So you can tell in the reverse also, no? And many people, you ask the question, where the zero is given, they say Aryabhatta. Aryabhatta has never told anything about zero. He has never told anything about zero. Wrong impression. Zero is there in Chandrashastra, Pingalacharya Chandrashastra. Rupe Shunyam, Dvishunyam, Shunyam Tadeva, Shunyam. So you know in Samaveda, 14 Shrutis are there. I'm sure you might not have heard it at all, luckily. So 14 Shrutis are there. Whenever some people chant Samaveda mantra, you look to their hand. First Shruti they will put like this, second Shruti they will put like this, third Shruti and fourth Shruti, fifth Shruti, sixth Shruti, like this it goes. 14th last Shruti is like this. This is Purnam. From this came zero. From this came Indian discovery of zero. Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyade Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyati. That is zero we have discovered, given in Chandrashastra of Pingalacharya. Fourth chapter, 32nd line, it is given. So, we have discovered that. Like this, so many are there. But we need not go to Vedas. Come to real Sanskrit. We have got, if you are asking who has discovered gravity, we will all say Sir Isaac Newton. I'll tell you that it is not neither Newton nor Oldton. It is Indians who have discovered that. Akrishti Shaktischa Mahitaya Yat Ghastam Guruswa Bhimugam Sachaktya Akrishyate Tat Padati Dibhati Same Samandat Kobadatyayam Ghe. It is Bhaskaracharya, Tu Siddhanta Shiromani, 6th chapter, 22nd line. The book is printed both in English and Sanskrit and also in Hindi by Motilal Banarsidas. And the book is available. We need not interpret or misinterpret something like that. The meaning is not that vague also. Akrishti, attracting. Shaktischa, with force. Mahi, earth. Swa, abhimugam, swashaktya, akrishyate. Is the meaning clear? Swa, abhimugam, swashaktya, akrishyate. Yet, akrishyate, tat patati iti bhati. Whichever is getting attracted, that falls down. Same samandat kvabadatyayam ghe. The celestial body is getting attracted among themselves. Where shall they fall? Where shall they fall? So this we need not go to the, we need not go to the Vedas. It is given in Sanskrit literature. So like this spherical shape of earth. We were taught that it is Copernicus or Silvernicus, something like that. But it is neither Copernicus nor Silvernicus. It is we. You know, if you are going to Bhagavadam, the 12 Skandha, 645 chapters are the Bhuvana Kosha Varnanam, in which Bhugola Adhyayam. Bhugola Varnanam is there. 7 chapters. Bhugolam. Bhu, you know what is meant by that. Golam. Golam word itself means spherical shape. Is it not? So Bhugola in Puranas are there. Forget about Puranas. Purana might have given stories and other things. But you know Aryabhatta has given Mrit Jalashigi Vayumayo Bhugola Sarvato Vritta. Mrit soil, jala, water, vayu, agni, shiki, agni. Mayo Bhugola Sarvato Vritta. So it is very specifically available. Not that we are claiming something not there at all. It is there, the Aryabhatiya book. It is published by Indian National Science Academy. And luckily the director of Indian National Science Academy does not know that one. It is published by INSA. But still it is published that. So, Nila Bhuvya Saha. 1050 Yojana is the diameter of Earth. So, Nila Bhuvya Saha. Correct. One Yojana is 8000 into the height of human being. Correctly it is given. So if you correct back calculate, you can see Earth's diameter is 1050 into 12.12 kilometer. Then compare with the modern value. You will be getting exact value. Earth's rotation is not discovered by Westerners, Leibniz, Kelvin or Magellan or thing. Pranena iti kalambuhu brahmayati. Earth revolution around the sun. Eko na shashti lipta ha. Ashtau vilipta. 59 angular minute at 8 angular second is the revolutionary speed of the earth around the sun. Exact value, not approximate value. And also another person, Pudumana Somayaji, has given in Katabayadi number system, Gopatnaya Dinadama is the revolution speed. Ga means 3, Pa means 1, Gopatnya 0, Ya 1, the 8 and 0, Dama 59 angular minute, 8 second, 10 decisecond, 13 microsecond is the angular velocity of the revolution of the earth around the sun. The book is available in Kerala University. The book name is Karanabaddhadi. The book is available. And not that when we have to go through misinterpretation of somebody about it. But most unfortunately, we do not know what is meant by Bhuta Sangya. We do not know what is meant by Kadabadyadi, the number system. We do not know what is meant by Adiabatiya number system. Without these three number system understanding, ancient Indian mathematics and ancient Indian astronomy is impossible. Without these three number system, impossible for anybody. Because everything is given in Bhuta Sangya. So all the theorem, and I tell you that sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, secant theta, cosecant theta, and cotangent theta is discovered in India using the theorem Chapachatat Palado Vitadvat Chabahadadhyadi Hadatri Maurya Labdhani Yukmani Balanya Dodas Chabada Yukmani Chavistar Ardhat Vinyasya Jovari Varitya Jed Tachesho Buja Kodi Gunau Bhaveta. The theorem written by Pudumana Somayaji, 1448 in Karanabaddhadi, full 6th chapter deals with sine theta and cos theta. 28 theorems are there. Now, unfortunately, these theorems are all known as Grigori's theorem 1-2, Leibniz's theorem 1-2, and Newton's theorem, forward extrapolation and backward, Euler's theorem, and Kepler's theorems, and so on. Another theorem is known as Tycho Brahe equation and theorem. All these in their name. And I am telling you all these things, I feel proud partly because the professor who produced 28 PhD and so many things and going to Delhi for project, he, when I heard his qualification, I got myself reduced into zero. But anyway, I found when I compiled all these theorems, and one copy I submitted to Deshiya Samskrita Vidyapidam, National Sanskrit Vidyapidam Tirupati. It's directly under UGC. Prahladacharya, Vice Chancellor, said that this deserves something more than that. He sent the copy to then Karnataka Governor, and Karnataka Governor told you give something more than PhD to him. So by changing the rule in UGC, they gave me Doctor of Literature for the science in Sanskrit. Only one scientist in India after 1947 who got Doctor of Literature. They used to give DSc but not DL. So all these theorem, almost all these theorem, Grigori's theorem, we have discovered it. It's about 250 years before the birth of the great grandfather of Grigori, we have discovered that. So, Vargair Yujambad Vigunair Nirekair Vargi Kridair Varjita Yukma Vargaihi Vyasam Chashadignam Vibajet Palam Swam Vyase Trinigne Paridistadasyat. You just see how complicated it is. Vargair Yujambad, take even number, take its square. Dvigunail, multiply it with 2. Nirekai, subtract 1. Vargi Varjita Vargi Krida Varjitai, -2 square. And Vyasam Chashadignam, multiply the diameter with the 6 and go on dividing the 6d divided by 2 raised to n minus 2 square and minus 2 raised to 2 square. Repeat it with the 2 square, 4 square, 6 square, 8 square till you are tired. Finally, you will be getting the correct value of circumference. So it is Grigori's theorem. So many theorems, 180 theorems we have compiled. Day before yesterday, I have uploaded in YouTube about 13 theorems or something like that. And next week I will be uploading some more theorems. If I upload all these theorems in the YouTube, no, nobody will be listening to that one, because they say we need black coffee for listening that. Otherwise it's very complicated. So the spherical shape of Earth, its rotation, its revolution, its declination, the latitude and longitude. You know how beautifully Aryabhatta has told Anulomagadir Nausta Pashyatya Chalam Vilomagamyadda Achalani Bhani Datta Samavastigamaga Anilangaya. How the earth rotation has been explained just like Anulomagadir Naustaha. The boat which is moving forward, you are standing in that and you are seeing Pashyati Achalam Vilomagamyadda. On either side, the trees and the houses and the plants are there. They will be going back when you are moving forward in the boat. Samapaschimaga achalani bhani tata. Since earth rotates from west to east, earth rotates from west to east, you see that the celestial bodies which are stagnant moving from east to west. So is there any interpretation, commentary or sub-commentaries needed for understanding all these things? But the wrong thing, the moment we listen to the Sanskrit words, we think that everything is in Veda. Wrong. It is not in Veda. It is in Jyotisha. You know, Vedas are there, Brahmanas are there, Aranyaka, Upanishad, Vedic literature, Shiksha, Niruktam, Vyakaranam, Chandashastram, Kalpashastram, Jyotisham, Vedanga, Arthashastra, Dhanurveda, Gandharva Veda, Ayurveda, Stapatya Veda, Upaveda, 18 Puranas, 18 Upapuranas, Shat Darshanas, 2 Itihasas. That is the Indian literature. Why we have got so many literature? Simple answer. Our forefathers knew pretty well that one literature is not enough for teaching everything for human being. That is what I used to tell to the Christians. One Bible is not enough for learning everything. One Quran is not enough for learning everything. We need thousands of books in thousands of written by thousands of rishis in thousands of subjects written for the last 10,000 years. Because you may be knowing that Indian Constitution written and approved in 1950. After that, we have amended nearly 157 times. Within something like 52 years, 157 amendments. So a book written 2000 years ago, how many amendments are needed? Can you use the same thing? You cannot use that. So amendments are needed. That is why we have got Rigveda, 27 recensions. Yajurveda, 108 recensions. Samaveda, 1001 recensions. Atharva Veda, 52 recensions. 18 books in Shiksha, 18 books in Nirukta, 18 books in Vyakarana, Chandashastra, and almost 200 ton Kalpashastra. I cannot say number. Only by weight I can tell. So Kalpashastra and Jyotisha, 18 books, 18 Purana, 18 Upapurana. Why? Our forefathers knew pretty well that one book is not enough. Is it clear to you? So many are needed. Addition, deletion, modification, corrections are needed. And that we did. So take mathematics, take astronomy. Go to the medical system, the latest new age therapy. Sharira Manaso Yoga Paraspara Manu Vrajeta Adhara Adheya Bhavena Taptajya Ghadayoriva. Mind and body exist complementary to each other. Any problems that the mind is facing, that will be affecting the body. Any problem that the body is facing, that will be affecting the mind. Just like hot oil poured into cold vessel, heat will be transferred from oil to vessel. If you are pouring cold oil to hot vessel, heat will be transferred from vessel to the oil. Could you understand what I said? Like that, any problem that the mind is facing, that will be affecting your body. Any problem that the body is facing, that will be affecting the mind. If you are driving your car in New York, you can see almost every 2 kilometers an arrow will be given. NAT center, new age therapy center. What is new age therapy? This yoga, this mantra therapy. And last year July 9th, I was fortunate enough to go to NASA. I found that almost a majority of the computers, Veda chanting is there. Many people are listening Veda mantra and doing work there. July 4th, I happened to go to George Martin's Hospital in New York. 600-bed heart surgical center. Almost everybody has got Veda mantra. July 12th, American Parliament session started by chanting Veda mantra by Dr. Zed. So America is coming to India. We are going to America. So not merely the mathematics. And very luckily what I found last time when I went, I happened to go to Canada, the Rainbow Bridge got washed out by the flood in Missouri, Mississippi. They are going to rebuild the bridge using iron pillar made with the composition of Delhi iron pillar. The composition of iron pillar that they are going to put in Missouri, Mississippi, Rainbow River is exactly this composition. You know, Delhi iron pillar. Delhi iron pillar has not rusted, even though Lalu Prasad Yadav is residing nearby that. So, it's a rustless. How perfection? BC 50, it has been meant. So, 30 kilograms of iron pieces forge welded together to 7 ton weighing 21 feet height, the top of which Ashoka Chakra was there, Ashoka Stamba was there, somebody stole it. So that iron pillar, even now you will not be seeing where that joint is there, forge welding. Now for metallurgy expertise there, if I tell a wrong word, it will be problematic, no? So for forge welding, you need 1140 or 1150 degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit. At that temperature, they could make this forge welding. Remember, in 50 BC, there was no diesel, no petrol, no coal, no electricity. Still, they could make the temperature. Even today, creating temperature above 1850 degrees is impossible without these three. But they could make it. So our technology was something super. Today morning, I happened to deliver a lecture in Kanchipuram. All the thing in Kanchipuram, many people outside us know, nobody in Kanchipuram knows about the speciality of the Gopuram. About the Kanchipuram Gopuram, RHS and LHS same. You know, if you put a mirror here, the civil engineering pattern of Kanchipuram Gopuram is so perfect. And it is constructed nearly 200 AD. And a cement produced in India. We used to get Portland cement from 1920 onwards. 1920 onwards, Portland cement used to come here and we used to construct our concrete building using Portland cement. If it rains, water will not go outside. But here in Padmanabha Swami temple and also go to this Kanchipuram temple, the pagodas and the corridor, not even a single drop of water will fall inside if it is raining torrentially even. So that cement, so many things. I'm just jerking from the mathematics to astronomy, astronomy to health science I jerked into iron pillar, just civil engineering. Why this fast movement? Not my mistake, it is his mistake. 45 minutes only given. Within 45 minutes, I have to complete all these things now. So take any branch. Just I am telling, now few quotation as such. Last time when I came here, I gave like this. William Harvey discovered blood circulation. Dhamanyo rektavahinaha chaturvimshadiradita kulya bhirivakedara rasta birdeho bhivardade. This is in Sangeeta Ratnakaram. Sharangadara wrote AD 900. Dhamanyo rektavahinaha, blood vessels carrying the blood are 24 numbers in our body. Chaturvimshati ratita kulyabiriva kedara. Just like tubes are used for taking water towards paddy field, like the water is taken to the paddy field in a tube, these blood vessels carry blood to all our body. So blood vessels, blood circulation, not discovered by William Harvey. The wave nature of sound. Vichi Taranganyayena Shabda Ulpatti, BC 300, Gautama Maharshi has explained it correctly. And Heisenberg uncertainty principle, you have known. ఏక సమయే చ ఉభయాన్ అనవధారణం. ఇఫ్ యు కెన్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ద సంస్క్రిట్ మీనింగ్, వెరీ సింపుల్. ఏక సమయే అట్ ఏ టైమ్, ఉభయాన్ టూ ప్రాపర్టీస్, అనవధారణం ఇంపాసిబుల్ టు పర్సీవ్. సో ఏక సమయే చ ఉభయాన్ అనవధారణం, ఫోర్త్ చాప్టర్ థర్డ్ లైన్ ఆఫ్ పతంజలిస్ యోగ శాస్త్ర. అండ్ డార్విన్స్ థియరం, జాత్యంతర పరిణామ ప్రకృత్యాపురాత్, ఎవల్యూషన్ ఆఫ్ ద లివింగ్ బీయింగ్ ఇస్ ద రూల్ ఆఫ్ ద నేచర్. అండ్ సో నైస్లీ దే హ్యావ్ గివన్ ద డెఫినేషన్ ఫార్ యాటమ్, అపకర్ష పర్యంతం ద్రవ్యం పరమాణురేవం, ఇన్ఫీరియర్ మోస్ట్ పార్టికల్ ఆఫ్ ఎ మ్యాటర్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ యాటమ్. పరమాణుర్ ఇది ప్రోక్త జ్ఞానీనాం దృష్టిగోచర, వాట్ వీ కాల్ యాజ్ పరమాణు క్యాన్ బి సీన్ ఓన్లీ బై సైంటిస్ట్స్. పరమాణు ఇది ప్రోక్త, వాట్ ఎవర్ వీ కాల్ యాజ్ పరమాణు, జ్ఞానీనాం దృష్టిగోచర, ఓన్లీ ద నాలెడ్జబుల్ పీపుల్ క్యాన్ సీ దాట్ అండ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ దాట్ వన్. సో సచ్ ఏ గుడ్ వే, యు నో విమాన శాస్త్ర రిటన్ బై భరద్వాజ. విమాన శాస్త్ర ఈస్ అ స్మాల్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎ బిగ్ బుక్. యు నో వాట్ ఈస్ దట్ బిగ్ బుక్? అంశుబోధిని. అంశుబోధిని హ్యాస్ గాట్ 160 చాప్టర్, అండ్ ఇన్ విచ్ 40th చాప్టర్ ఈస్ విమానతంత్ర. విమానతంత్ర ఈస్ స్ప్లిట్ ఇన్ టు 55 చాప్టర్స్, అండ్ ఇట్ స్టార్ట్స్ విత్ ద లైన్ దేశ దేశాంతరం యద్ధత్ లోక లోకాంతరం తదా ద్వీప ద్వీపాంతరం చైవ యో అంబరే గంధు అర్హతి స విమాన ఇది ప్రోక్త ఖేడ శాస్త్ర విదాంబరై. సో దేశ దేశాంతరం యద్దత్ ఫ్రమ్ వన్ కంట్రీ టు అనదర్ కంట్రీ, ద్వీప ద్వీపాంతరం తదా ఫ్రమ్ వన్ ఐలండ్ టు అనదర్ ఐలండ్, దేశ దేశాంతరం యద్వీప లోక లోకాంతరం తదా ఫ్రమ్ వన్ లోకా టు అనదర్ లోకా. యో అంబరే గంధు అర్హతి, త్రూ ద స్కై ఇట్ గోస్. స విమాన ఇతి ప్రోక్త, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ విమానం. దట్ నేమ్ ఈస్ గివన్ బై ఖేడ శాస్త్ర విదాంబరై, దోస్ హు ఆర్ ఎక్స్పర్ట్ ఇన్ స్పేస్ సైన్స్ దే గేవ్ దిస్ నేమ్. సో 40th చాప్టర్ ఆఫ్ అంశుబోధిని డిస్క్రైబ్స్ అబౌట్ విమాన శాస్త్ర. ఇటాలియన్ సైంటిస్ట్ హావ్ టేకన్ 12 patents from that. That is available in the journal of the Heritage Science, Indian National Science Academy publish one journal every 3 months, a very nice journal they have published it. And also the 160 chapters in Amshubodhini, of which 109th chapter is spectrophotometer. 109th chapter starts like this: ద్వంద ప్రమాపకం నామ నవోత్తర శతాత్మకం యంత్రం భరద్వాజేన ధీమతా విరచితం. ద్వంద ప్రమాపకం నామ, ద నేమ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ స్పెక్ట్రోఫోటోమీటర్ విచ్ క్యాన్ బి యూస్డ్ ఫర్ మెషరింగ్ యువి ఐఆర్ విసిబుల్ రైస్ అండ్ హీట్ రైస్ ఇట్స్ నోన్ యాజ్ ద్వంద ప్రమాపకం నామ. నవోత్తర శతాత్మకం యంత్రం 109th యంత్ర ఇన్ అంశుభూతిని. ఇట్ హాస్ గాట్ 32 పార్ట్స్ అండ్ thorough study has been conducted by Professor N.G. Dongre, Saha Institute, and he has taken 14 patents from that. And whatever Dwanta Pramapaka Yandram developed by him has been kept in IIT Delhi. If you go there, you can see that. So it is not merely speculations or miracles, something like that. You can directly see. You know, in Indian science stands in four pillar. Indian science stands in four pillar. What are the four pillar? First pillar, Pratyaksham Pramanam. Second pillar, Shastram Pramanam. Third pillar, Aptavakyam Pramanam. Fourth pillar, Anumanam Pramanam. So scientific proofs are available. Pratyaksham Pramanam, seeing is believing. Shastram Pramanam, science is the base of everything. And aptavakyam pramanam, opinion of the scholars can be taken as the basis. Anumanam pramanam, guessing and estimating, guesstimating is the pramanam for that. So four pramanas, So scientific, logical, rational, nicely. So Shastram Pramanam from Bhagavad Gita, Aptavakyam Pramanam from Dharma Shastra, Pratyaksham Pramanam from Gautama's Nyaya Shastra, Anumanam Pramanam from Ayurveda. So foolproof Indian scientific knowledge. Why should we learn Indian scientific knowledge when we are living in the 21st century, ultra modern scientific era? Why should we learn these things? First thing, for feeling proud that I am an Indian. If you are an Indian, next question, why you are proud of being an Indian? Because the past of this country is so glorious. When I was delivering a lecture in Kuwait, I asked the question to the students, do you know when Kali Yuga started? No student answered that. I'm sure none of you will also answer. But after 2 minutes, one student stood up and said, sir, I know when Kali Yuga started. Then I said, if I would have asked this question when Kali Yuga started in India, not even a single student would have answered. But now in Kuwait, one student is answering that. Great. Please tell me when Kali Yuga started. Immediate with courage, just like Swami Vivekananda said, Ma Bi, fearless way, he said, 1947, August 15th. So Kali Yuga started 1947, August 15th. Then I said, exactly, it is not that. It may be true also, because up to 1947, August 15th, foreigners destroyed our culture and heritage. After that, we took the responsibility of destroying that. Then that way it is all. But literally Kali Yuga started during 3102 BC, February 17th, Thursday, midnight, 11:55. BC 3102, February 17th, Thursday, midnight, 11:55, Earth, Moon, Sun, Mercury, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, and Venus came directly in the Alpha Aries point. The Alpha Aries point. So that yoga of Graha created the yuga. You know, up to 1820, world over, AD, BC was not used. Only KE was used. Luckily, nobody knows, including we ourselves. KE, Kali era. And after 1820, all the past were recalculated with the AD, BC. Otherwise, it is not there. Only Kali era, time corrections and everything was done based on Kali era, because it is based on an astronomical parameter. AD, BC, that is not based on an astronomical parameter. It is based on Jesus Christ. BC means before Christ. AD means after our God. So during our God, what is the number? Before Christ, BC. After our God is AD. So during these 63 years, what is there? That's the second letter of Malayalam or Tamil. What is second letter of Malayalam or Tamil? We do not know. So we do not know what happened during the period of Jesus Christ. So that is enough for them. But for us, it is not enough. Because their whole history starts after 800 AD. Our history goes back to, as I told you, Dr. A.K. Vishwas and Dr. B.K. Vishwas, Minerals and Metals of India, is Banaras Hindu University and IIT, Kanpur, IIT Lucknow and IIT Kharagpur. They have combinedly done the studies of thousands of materials using Geiger-Müller counter, and found that our history goes back to BC 8275. The oldest artifact discovered from Kalibangan, Bhagavanpura, Mehargarh, Chinchudaro, Bhagavanpura, and so on places. English people wanted to keep Indian history up to 1500 BC. You know what is the reason? They never allow Indian history go beyond 1500 BC. Because Adam and Eve, these two fellows born on 3112, October 4th at 12 o'clock. So before that, human being should not be there in the earth at all. Even though we have got 69,000 year old human body, that should be after Adam and Eve only. This problem they always wanted to see. Indian history never goes beyond a particular thing. But our Dr. Rao and hundreds and thousands of modern scientists, particularly metallurgists, they have gone deep into these things. And our Kali Yuga era calculations and history and archaeological evidences calculation. If you happen to go to Lothal, you can see an industrial estate which was in full swing during 3500 BC. Even now it is there intact. 3500 BC industrial estate with a 1 square kilometer artificial lake from where shipment of everything took place to Mesopotamia and Babylonia. Should it? And if you go to Rajasthan, I am sure he might have seen the minerals and metals of zinc, lead, copper, ambamata, and mines and other things excavated during Vedic period still remaining intact. So the zinc and lead metallurgy, so many things. If you go through all these things, whether it is mathematics, astronomy, and health science, then Ayurveda, yoga, and metallurgy, you will know that Indian scientific heritage is something beyond the level. Why we should learn heritage? For feeling proud that we are Indian. Why we should learn our heritage? We should inform the world that we have discovered Grigori's theorem, Leibniz's theorem, Euler's theorem. We have discovered the value of pi. Pi chaturadhikam shatamashta gunam dvashashtistada sahasranam ayudadvaya vishkambasya asanno savratta parinaha. We have discovered Pythagoras theorem, Dirka Chadrasra Sekshanaya Rajyuho Parshwamani Thiryanmani Chayat Pradak Bhude Kuritastat Ubayam Karoti. We have to inform the world. One thing I am sure, Americans have got open mind. English people also have got open mind. But the Indians create problem. They keep the mind closed and never allow others to open their mind also. That is the problem. So, when I handed over that thesis which gave me Doctor of Literature to Cambridge University professor, the professor told me one thing. Till now we were thinking that the science started from Greek, but you have brought a book with the proof, with the date, with the name of the book and the chapter and line. This is what we wanted. Many people claim that everything was there, everything is there. No. Many people say nothing was there, nothing is here. Some people say we have discovered something. All the three concepts are wrong. Nothing existed here is wrong. Everything existed here, wrong. Something was here, wrong. Here we have so many things even utilized, used in the 21st century also. So we should inform the world that we have discovered the spherical shape. Now it has appeared in Encyclopedia Britannica. Gravity is discovered by Bhaskaracharya. Latest edition. And you see, so many things there. Why? If we keep quiet, world will not know about. World is not against India or Indians. But we do not have the courage to inform the world that we have discovered. But I also want to tell, in 2010, one Givargis from Kerala, he has uploaded so many theorems discovered in India to the Manchester University website, all luckily taken from my book, and don't worry about it. Still he has uploaded it, and world over people started appreciating that. But he has done of his soul. 2010, it appeared in almost every Indian newspaper. Hindu newspaper gave in front page, Times of India gave in the front page with his picture. So when we claim, we inform the world that one we have discovered it, naturally world will be having an open mind to take it as their thing. In fact, I taught a group of officials in American military how to use Bhuta Sangya, how to use Kadabayadi number system. They want to use that number system for their secret code. They are used, nobody can understand in the world, particularly Indians. So,
Uta sangya and kadabayadi number system. So nicely, one number, you have got enough words. So many words are there. So first, for feeling the pride that I am an Indian, we have to learn. Second, inform the word. Third, apply in our day-to-day life. The heritage knowledge, Bhagavad Gita is the part of the syllabus in the MBA in Harvard University. Dr. Prahladacharya, you know, last year, that Business Week has given that cover story. Gita becomes the new mantra for the big biz in US. That title of the cover story, Gita becomes the new mantra for the big biz. Biz means business community in US. And four page full article of Bhagavad Gita. 186 universities in America teach Bhagavad Gita in America. America is not ruled by BJP. So remember that they are utilizing. So our knowledge they are using. 17 American universities teach Ayurveda directly. Almost 37 American people, they follow yoga. 64% of the New York population above 40, they do this pranayama and meditation. Take for that matter, Indian music is spreading world over. Vedic mathematics is studied in NASA as $6 million worth project in Vedic mathematics. And so Indian food system, one girl from Cleveland University came, two girls from Cleveland University came here, and she visited Karnataka, Andhra, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, found that 3,200 type of curries can be made using bendi. 3,200 type of curries can be made using lady's finger. She got shocked. She wrote that as her MPhil thesis. Bindi curry as MPhil thesis. Why I said that one? Because I used to go and take classes in Cleveland University very frequently. Every year I used to go there June 30th. Used to come back by August 2nd. This year I said I am not coming because I frequently visit the same thing. I do the telephone. Telespeeches sitting in my home through the land phone to New York University, 465 students sitting 8 a.m. to 10:15 a.m. Nearly 2 hours. So that is enough. My going there is not needed also. So they are coming to India. World over, people are stretching their hand for Indian knowledge. My question, can you give the knowledge? They are ready to take. They are ready to take anything. The moment you reach there, they will be asking, you know how to chant the Veda mantra? The first question, Agnimile Purohitam Yajnasya Deva Mrityujam Hoda Aram Ratnadadamam Agni Porve Eber Shibir Idyo Nudanairuta Sadevang Eha Vakshati Agnina Arayimashnavata. This is the line Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam frequently used to quote to tell the students that you should give light and heat to the people just like Agni. Our forefathers worshipped Agni. And that Rigveda has been considered now as the World Heritage by UNESCO, not Bible and Quran. These Vedas are considered as the World Heritage very recently. So many a times to you, politely, I would like to say, we are ignorant about Indian heritage. That is a pardonable mistake. But we are ignorant that we are ignorant. That is not a pardonable mistake. At least be aware that we are ignorant. And I would like to tell, I'm sure the time is over. Some CDs and VCDs and pen drives and memory cards I have kept there. One of the pen drive is only 600 hours of speech. And another English is 160 hours speech. Next week we are bringing 1000 hours speech in 4 GB. Vedas available in 1 GB. 1 GB in MRL format. So my request, none of the CDs have got copyright. Take as many copies as possible and spread it to anyone. And if you want to sell the copies, you sell it and construct a house and I will come for inaugurating that. So our forefathers have created. Give to everyone. send it to everyone so that let every Indian feel that they are the proud inheritors of Bharat Mata's treasury, Bharatam, Bhava Raga Talam. A country which has got Bhava Raga Talam. We are the proud inheritors of that. Pray every day, morning and evening. If you have got 10 more Janma, let all the 10 Janma be on the lap of Mother India. She is there, she was there, and she will be with you. And one of the greatest, one person in America, was Manitoba University in Canada, was asking me a question, what is the greatest wonder in the world? He was asking some question in a underground negative way. I told him, the greatest wonder in the world is a Sikh Prime Minister, a Hindu President, a Muslim Vice President, a Christian Defense Minister, all the four are ruled by an Ammachi from Italy. That is the greatest wonder. And your Pisa Gopuram, Eiffel Tower, that anybody can construct. And Eiffel Tower, if you are constructing, automatically PWD engineer, if he construct, it will automatically leave. Nothing special. But this country, still it is going very smoothly without any problem. That is the greatest country. With these words, I would like to tell you, how long you are living is less important. How you are living is more important. About 26,500 days you are living here, eating about 60 tons of food. Last century this day you are not here. Next century this day also you are not here. Nimisham jolitam shreyam natu dhumayitum chiram. If you are living even a 1 second, eject light and heat to others and glow. Let your light, knowledge, since you are from IIT, your words will be valuable for everyone. So your words, your messages, your knowledge, that will be valued by everyone. Go to the world and tell that India was great, India is great, India will be great. The three persons in the world who never smiled nor cried. First, Lord Krishna. He never smiled nor cried. Second, Veda Vyasa. Never smiled nor cried. The third, Dr. Manmohan Singh. Never cried. So, a great country. I always would like to tell my deepest gratitude for inviting me for delivering this lecture. That. And once again, I would like to express Dirgha, Ayura Arogya, Aishwaryanam, Abhivruddhirastu, Uttara Uttara Abhivruddhirastu, Idi Aham, Prarthayami, long, long, happy and prosperous, very prosperous and glorious, useful, fruitful, purposeful and peaceful life. Always remember the message of Swami Vivekananda, Uttishtada, gloriously stand up, Jagrada, be aware that you are not permanent here. Prapyavara Nibodada, enlighten yourself by acquiring knowledge from the scholars. And with these words, once again, my pranams. If you have got email address, make it a point to give there in our counter there, where we have kept the CDs, because we used to send Thursday message, Dharma message, and a special message to 4.8 lakhs people every week. You will also be getting that one. It will be useful for you. If you are giving the email, you will also be getting our website, www.iash.org. 42,000 hours material we have uploaded in our website. One is the biggest digital library of Indian heritage. And 4,800 hours of speeches I have uploaded in YouTube. You just go to YouTube, give Dr. N, that is enough, you will get. Need not go to Gopalakrishnan also. Thank you very much. My pranams.